onto the right side to our Bionic Learning Network area. In the last years, we had a lot of animals on our trade fairs. Then we had kangaroos, we had butterflies,
birds, penguins,
so many animals.
Amazing zoo, yeah.
That's true. And this year we also have an animal. But first, let's talk about the human hand. We have brought one. Our colleagues prepared something very, very special.
Can make shake hands here.
Yeah.
Realistic force feedback.
Great.
So, hi guy.
How are you?
Also wave a little bit. We select the mode.
BionicSoftHand.
This is a pneumatic robot arm. And this pneumatic inside is using textile structures. And you see it's not dangerous at all to touch it as it is moving along. And we have a silicone skin on top, and you can see in the first rows there are a lot of sensor points inside to have tactile feedback and also position feedback. The hardware is already fascinating on itself because it's very compact, very flexible, but even more interesting is the programming. How do you program and learn with such a robot arm? And I'm just starting a demonstrator here. We used a very specific reinforcement learning algorithm together with a partner company to develop a system that helps us in a very short time period to program such a hand and to train moving cubes, for example. And here we use reinforcement learning and a digital twin. And if you have only one digital twin, it takes the software a while to do all these trainings. So we decided to have massive parallel learning. So we multiplied these digital twins several times and started learning in all of these platforms. Now, one had perhaps a great idea on how to handle the cube. So the whole team shared the information and got a level higher. And they trained again on the new level. And again, one had perhaps a great idea. Same happened to the whole team. And after a while, we had already a nice model, which we had been able to copy back from the digital environment into the real one. And demonstrating now the result is achieved and the cube can be turned, and you will see that tube element at the end of this bionic station. Great software cooperation and great inspiration for the potential future with robotics.
Fascinating.
New way of man-machine interaction, yeah.
Absolutely, a fascinating technology. Also the second one that we want to talk about, this was the BionicSoftHand and this is called the BionicSoftArm. In the last years we had the elephant trunk here on our trade fair stand, and this is elephant trunk number 3456 because it's much better.
Been a lot of development steps in between.
Yeah.
Now you see a much more flexible elephant trunk by using also textile bellow structures in the middle and some new bending